Well, keloid is a benign or non-cancerous scar tumor, which usually happens after some type of injury to the skin. The difference between it and other scars is that it grows past the site of injury. You look at some of the studies, it's more common in people with darker skin. Some studies show that it's up to 15 to 20% of that population are affected with keloids. So you can get keloids anywhere in the body where you get any type of injury. They are most common in the earlobe area for the head and neck region. And because of that, they're going to be more common in females because of the frequent ear piercing.
I was kind of scared. And then I thought about my aunt and her keloid. So I did research trying to find out, like, what is this? Is it cancer? Is it because I have the earrings up here? And I, after a while in the research, I got it. I'm like, it's from the earrings because it's on both ears and they did get infected.
The traditional way of treating keloids is using a steroid injection, plus or minus doing surgical excision, so you remove the keloid. And even with those treatments, the chances of it coming back is up to 50%.
For the first few times I had it removed about four times total now. And the first two times I never knew truly what was going on. I come back to Dr. Jones every 4 to 6 weeks to get a cortisone injection. And cortisone is basically a steroid that slows down your healing process. So hopefully it'll slow mine down enough to where it would be a normal healing process of a regular person. So far it's great. The back of my ear, you know, because it has the round bulge. As of right now, it's still flat. I don't feel any hardening of, you know, scar tissue forming. Obviously, there's going to be a little bit just because it is a scar, but it's still pretty soft, and yep, I'm excited so far.
The rest of the treatments really haven't shown any more benefit as a group than the sort of gold standard treatments. One of the problems with getting keloids treated in the past because people looked at it as a cosmetic deformity, which it is, but keloids can also be have other symptoms like pain, they itch, they can cause decreased function.
It was big. Dr. Jones just took that off. It was maybe that big at the top of my ear, so it was just hanging at the top in the back of my ear.
We don't know why it starts. We don't know sort of the biology or the molecular things that are going on that makes people at risk. So my goal is to use some novel or what we consider innovative new techniques to study the molecular biology of keloids with the hopes that it will allow us to identify who would be at risk for developing keloids and also give us some insights on what are new and better treatment options.
I always kept my keloids covered up with my hair. I could never wear my hair up. Since I was 16, I haven't worn my hair up, so I can't wait for this summer to wear it up.